Hello guys, I'm in the theaters, first time after the lockdown, and I'm here to watch Tenet by Christopher Nolan. And guess what? This will be my first Nolan film in a theater. And it's open guys, I'm going in. Oh my god, excited.
Good morning guys. Today, I'll be vlogging my way to going to theaters to watch Tenet, Christopher Nolan. Hopefully it all goes well. My first Nolan movie in theater. I should document it, so let's get ready.
Now, one thing to note is eat something before going to theater. Before COVID, if you haven't eaten anything, the smell of popcorn will drive you crazy. So definitely eat something because the film is long, 2 hours, 30 minutes, and you'll feel hungry. I'm ready. Let's go. Wait. Mask. Let's get that. And now we are ready.
Okay, now this is sad. It's empty. So, mummy!
All ready, let's go.
Okay, let's sanitize first. Please. Bye, mummy! I'm excited. Seat belt, very important, and it's all about safety. So let's go. You can judge my driving skills. That was not good. See, there is a health concern, of course, going to a theater, but I feel out of all the places, theater is the most. So it's a bad idea to record while you're on a traffic light. Don't do that. Stop the vehicle and do it. So I was gonna say that safety is important, and I think theaters are one of the safest places, you know, compared to a market or somewhere, because in theater it's closed environment, everyone is checked, sanitized, so it's more safer. But still, I would not recommend everyone to go to theaters and watch the film, because I don't know how they will handle themselves and how the theaters will handle themselves. So it's all individual. If you can manage it to go, but I don't know. Hopefully you guys can hear me, the audio is good enough. First time doing it. I'm excited. I feel good. Want to go back after 8 months. Want to see the movie in a theater. And that too, a Christopher Nolan film. So, double bonanza. I think it's time. It's time to go inside the theater.
After so long, I'm so excited to enter a theater. I have to buy the tickets yet, so you have to wait for it. Morning show, so the whole mall is empty. And I'm finally here after 8 months. Cannot wait.
What can I help you?
Tenet, 10:45.
The mobile number?
959. So this is what INOX promises. Frequent cleaning. Everything is cleaned. Mask mandatory. That's good. So I have to wait 10 minutes. That's the new rule. You can only enter 10 minutes before your show. So I have to wait around. The mall is empty. We can roam around for some time. Or we can talk. So let's go. In such a long time, I tried this. So I have 10 to 20 minutes to waste. I'm early. So let's talk. So Tenet. I remember, you know, when I went to watch Star Wars, Rise of Skywalker, it had, I was in IMAX. So it had that 5 minutes attached footage of Tenet. And that footage didn't get understand anything. But it was in a theater and they had to rescue someone, and at the end it blasted. So that was it. It looked amazing and cannot wait to see the film. A lot of reviews are coming that it's too confusing, it's too much, just in the sake of confusion you're making a film. And I've heard these things every time these films come out. So I'm going fresh in watching the film myself, understanding it and not having any preconceived notions. Hopefully you guys can hear me. In the mask. You know, now I realize how difficult it would be for Deadpool, Spider-Man to talk in a mask. It looked like this, right?
So I'm inside the theater.
but no posters, man. That is disappointing. What will I do for the thumbnails? I don't know. I have no clue. There's one good thing that there are sanitizer stands everywhere. That's good to see. But no poster, no poster of Tenet. What will I do? I should act as if there's a poster and put it in the post. I can do that. This is the only popcorn I can afford to take a video of. This is really exciting. We can do this. This is really fun. 3000 is nothing, man. But how many people? How many you want? That's a question. And it's open, guys. I'm going in. Oh my god. Excited.
We are constantly on our toes to frequently deep clean and disinfect all customer touch points. Please maintain at least 6 feet physical distance outside the auditorium. Please keep wearing masks at all times. Maintain respiratory etiquettes and on round the clock to make you feel safe as home.
Finally, in the theater, cannot wait to watch the film. See you on the other side. Okay, it's interval time and going to watch though, but oh my god, the theater experience, nothing can beat it, not at all, nothing. I like that there were subtitles, that's really helpful. I heard the dialogues are not audible, so subtitles helps. And there's a flat, I think in the beginning it said the film is shot in a flat format. I don't understand what is that. So it will not be projected on the whole screen, but that's fine. I'm just getting to watch it in the theater. A lot of thoughts, I would say little confusion. I'm not grabbing everything, it's going too fast. Hopefully in the second half everything works well, and yeah, trying to, you know, not put my hands on my face, trying to restrain every time, being safe and enjoying the experience, enjoying the film theater experience. Nothing can beat it. And you know that experience of watching trailers, oh my god. In the beginning I saw Suryavanshi trailer, I saw Fast and Furious, and I loved it watching it theater. So see you later. Christopher Nolan, man. Lot of thoughts. I see the criticism the film is getting. I understand why people feel it's confusing, and you know, I also some thoughts of mine, but oh man. Lot of thoughts. They like Inox, they kept it all clean, a lot of like sanitizers everywhere, felt safe, felt better, and hopefully we'll be coming back for Wonder Woman and whatever other new films come to theatres, so definitely I'll be coming. I just wonder, man, how does he think, how does he write, you know, where does he start? I just wonder how he does do it. Oh, and here we are. So, thoughts. Let's start with, you know, some of the things people pointed out. It is definitely confusing than other of his films, because in other films he has, you know, had people, you know, explain things what's happening, and it's easier to understand and easier to follow. Like, you may not, you know, explain it all in once, you may have to study it and all, but even Inception, Interstellar, it's understandable. But here what happens, the explanation part is only so difficult to understand and you're unable to follow how things are happening. But what works is, while watching the film you don't understand how things are happening. By the end, oh, I get it now, but I still cannot explain what how it's happening. I understand while watching the film, I understand how the film is flowing, and of course there'll be a lot of explanation videos for this, a lot of people will be doing. I may have to watch some to understand everything. Of course it's difficult to understand everything in one watch, so definitely we have to do that. And thankfully there were subtitles, as I mentioned before. I'll not go to spoilers, no spoilers in this video, I'll try to refrain from it, but a lot of things I called it while the movie was going on, and I was right. But again, I don't know how it happened, and I have to study entropy now. I remember studying it in, I think, 11th 12th chemistry, but Delta G, am I right? No idea. Okay, so just got some groceries my mother asked for. And yes, so talking about the emotions and, you know, the character relationships, I feel the criticism is very right, because compared to Interstellar and Inception, where we are heavily, you know, emotionally connected to the characters, here the emotions don't really work.
like when you know the characters are getting emotional about the relationships, I don't feel anything, and that's the issue. I'm sure this one definitely deserves a live, and you guys let me know when do you want it, because we'll discuss spoilers in that. We can in that. In this, I'm not going to discuss any spoilers. Okay, I'm home finally, free from the mask. And you know, thinking about if I had seen it on OTT or on my laptop or something, I would have definitely, you know, paused and went back. What did he say? I didn't understand. Try to understand again and again. You know, I would have done that. But in theater, you cannot. And just watching the film as it is, without interrupting and stopping and, you know, trying to see what really happened and just go with the flow, it's a different experience. Now, it is a good experience or not, I cannot comment, but a theater experience is really, really different. And this film, I just enjoyed it. Man, after 8 months, I just enjoyed watching it on theaters. The trailers in the beginning, the big screen, the loud sound, and I just enjoyed the hell out of it.
Back home, I really forgot about how good the action was in the film. Really, really well done. All the sequences, action sequences, the set pieces. You know, Nolan got a lot of criticism, you know, for the action sequences in Dark Knight. He improved it, and in Rises, he improved it, but it was still not the best. And in this one, he did a really, really good job. And I think he took that criticism to heart. It was really, really well done. And all the action sequences, everything, like, technically it was brilliant film. Like, there was no doubt. Only thing which point I had to point out is the editing. I don't know. See, it's a Christopher Nolan film. I cannot call it a mistake. There's a purpose for everything. So maybe it's that, but there was some random, you know, editing and sometimes continuity errors. I don't know if what they purposely did that. They were trying something, you know, to show the difference or something like that. But, and yes, the print was censored. It was censored, so it can be the censor board. The editing can be the problem of that. So I may have to, you know, watch the Blu-ray version to understand again, maybe to comment on the editing. But overall, it was good. And we are back home. So guys, if you like this a vlog, something different for a different film and a very special film, so if you enjoyed it, hit the like button, share this video, comment below your thoughts, and subscribe if you haven't. Check out the videos, and I'll see you next time.